Geek Lifers, it is Saint coming at you at our 2018, see if I can say this in one take, swimsuit shoot.
Woo!
Yeah!
Swimsuit!
It is a beautiful Sunday out here tonight. A little hot, a little sweaty, but we're living. Mm-hmm. And we are here today with the ever lovely and amazing Amber Skies Cosplay.
Hey! What's up, guys?
How you doing today?
I'm fabulous.
Good.
It's, like you said, hot and sticky.
Yep, having a good time. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Awesome. For the viewers who don't know, what are you cosplaying
today? Oh, I am an amalgamation, mishmash, Frankenstein of a bunch of Starfire's different outfits from DC.
I love it.
Because she's either like wearing an outfit that's this big or like is a full top, and I'm like, I don't want to do either of those things. I don't want like tiny little you-know-what covers, and I also don't want like so much fabric. I'm going to be hot and sweaty.
Well,
so
I was
like, bathing suit. So
looks great.
Perfect.
Looks great.
Perfect opportunity to like mix all those things together.
Go.
So Starfire from DC.
I love it. Yeah. All right, so you are pretty well known in the cosplay community, especially here in Arizona. Everybody loves you. So we got to know, how did you start this all out? Where did your journey begin with cosplay?
Well, let's see, at this point, it's been about like 6 years I've been doing it like professionally now, but I've been dressing up since I was teeny tiny. my dad is an artist, my grandma was an artist, and I did theater growing up. So a lot of what we see in my tendencies today stemmed from the fact that I was just immersed in art when I was small. And I grew up doing acting on stage, and my dad actually owned a game store. It was like a computer gaming arcade and like
That's
a World
amazing.
Of Warcraft and a Warhammer 40K tabletop gaming store. So,
so
my best friends were like 40-year-old sweaty men that went to college. All the time.
I love it.
So
when
I was
good
like
company,
eight, I was. And they got me used to going to cons and stuff. And so as I grew up, I started to look around and see all these people in cool outfits. And I was like, wait, you know, instead of just like looking at all these cool people over here, why can't I do that too? And so it grew into me taking all of my different loves of art and mishmashing them all together.
That
and so here I am today.
Brilliant, and the perfect way that you should raise your child immersed in all the geekiness.
Take them to cons, man.
Good job, Amber Skies Cosplay's parents.
Dad's guys.
There you go.
We call him Dad's guys.
Oh, Dad's guys. All
he
right.
truly has
guys.
A moniker now. He is known.
Really?
Throughout. Yes. It sounds silly, but he's with me at like everything, and so we call him Dad's guys, and he loves it.
Love it. That is so wholesome and the best thing I've ever heard in my life.
I know. Awesome. I love that man.
So you said you were doing cosplay for like 6 years now.
Yeah, yeah.
You've been to a lot of cons. You've traveled a couple cons, right?
I
think there was like one time like the LA News did something
about
you.
Yeah.
So
I've gotten pretty lucky over my time.
That is so cool. So. Out of all the cons that you've been to, what is like the highlight and like the lowest of everything? Like what is the best and the worst moment you've ever had at a convention?
Oh gosh. Let's see. Well, the worst, it kind of just, I always think that everything's the end of the world, so I'm just a wee bit dramatic that way, but I'm okay. Nothing truly terrible has ever happened to me, thankfully, at a con. Most recently, I guess you could say, when I was judging for Phoenix Comic Fest and the fire alarm went off.
Oh, no.
And I had to emergency evacuate over 60 contestants for the masquerade down a set of fire escape stairs.
That was so tragic.
And
so
I, as a judge, had to, like, help them. Most people who couldn't step downstairs, you had to go down the stairs. So there was no other option. So we broke a lot of people's costumes in transit trying to emergency evac them out of the building. And that made me really sad because there were some people that spent like hundreds of hours making their things.
So
and then we had
tragic.
To run them out of the building because fire, we didn't know what was going on. Mm-hmm. Turns out there wasn't a fire. It was just in a false alarm. And
better safe than sorry.
I know. And then we had to, of course, do our best, the judges and myself. Mm-hmm. And we did the masquerade judging on the streets of downtown Phoenix. Mm-hmm. We literally, at the steps of the Herberger Theater, lined everybody up in order. We told all the normies to go away, and we had our pre-judging outside at like 10 o'clock at night.
Like
and
wholesome memories, though.
Yeah. I was like, oh, that's
events.
Pretty awful, but you know, we made the best of it, and then we ended up having the masquerade the next day instead.
Oh, there
so
you
we
go.
Rescheduled
okay.
and did our best, but
that's
probably like the worst, just because it was so inconvenient.
That is like a really bad one, though.
Yeah,
like, that is probably
sad.
The worst I've ever heard.
And
that
it was
so
nobody's
sad.
Fault either. That was the worst part of all. It's like, everyone's blaming the show, everyone's blaming the building. It's like people, like, it was a faulty wire. Like, it wasn't anybody's fault, thankfully, so nothing actually bad happened. But anyway, so I would say that's the worst, but to get to the best. My favorite and / coolest thing that's ever happened to me is my favorite character that I've ever cosplayed and has bought me like the most opportunities is Nebula from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Nebula is amazing.
And so I have like waist length blonde hair underneath all of this, and I have to like roll it all up and put it in a bald cap and do body paint and crazy cyborg stuff. And because of Nebula, I was actually recognized by Marvel for my work.
Mm-hmm.
And Marvel paid for me to come out to LA and go to a movie studio where they like shoot things for Marvel. and they had me do promo work for them, and I was the first episode of a new series on their YouTube channel called Marvel Becoming. And so they got to watch me get ready from like plainclothes Amber all the way through to Nebula.
Really?
And it was a video compilation we filmed for like 2 days, and it was like these giant cameras and flashing lights, and like I felt like I was in the movie.
That
so
is so surreal.
It was
like,
amazing.
How 6 years ago when you were just starting out like cosplaying, did you ever think that was ever going to be a
God,
thing?
Oh, God, no. And so from that, like that one YouTube video, it spiraled into so many other things. Because of that video, I got invited back by another friend of mine who does a lot of party producing in LA. And I got to go to Stan Lee's 95th birthday party as part of the entertainment for the evening. So they had me come as Nebula, and I got to like hug Grandpa Stan and like talk with him, and so I got to help celebrate his birthday, so that was really special.
That is so fun.
It's just
that
been amazing. And getting
fun
to know Karen Gillan, too, the actress that
plays
Nebula.
Gosh, and like even
she and I are like on a first name basis at this
are
point
you
because,
kidding?
yeah, I've seen her like 3 or 4 times now, and every time she's like,
that's amazing.
I'm fangirl crying. I'll never recover from that. So that one character and getting on the bandwagon at just the right time with a little bit of luck and some really awesome photographer friends.
And I mean, you just look so crazy cool all the time, so it's like, it's only like a matter of time until you get that recognition. Like, you deserve it. It's well deserved. But that's so cool. So, your cosplays are all very, very, very complex.
I sure like, try. This is,
right?
this is a simple day for me.
Did it start out so simple today, I heard?
No, it didn't. Okay, so here's the fun part. So you asked like worst things that have happened. Well, this is not the worst thing that's happened, but this is like my first, I think in a while, full-blown cosplay failure this morning. Oh. I got up at like 8 in the morning. I was like, oh, my shoot's not till 3. I've got plenty of time. And I had bought myself some alcohol-based airbrush body paint. I've been airbrushing for a while now, so I was like kind of used to it. But I'd never used this particular brand before, and I bought what I assumed was going to be the right amount of paint. You're catching where I'm going with this. And so starting at 8 o'clock, not only did all 3 of my nozzle heads for my airbrush gunk up and clog, which meant that about like this much paint was coming out rather than like a nice stream that I could paint with, but I ran out of paint 3/4 of the way through the process. So I like did my face, my arms, my belly, my back.
Oh,
I got all
no.
the way to like my knees, and I was going to go back and do final touches, and
you're just like,
and I was out of paint, and all 3 of my things were clogged. It was 2:30, and I was like, oh my God! So I like, I had to get in the shower, scrub it all off, and
it was like, of course, like it was like the bathing suit swimsuit.
Oh,
too.
If
it was
course.
Like any other outfit, you probably
anything.
Like,
I
didn't need my
fine,
today,
but I had to cover like
good.
Every orifice,
right.
And so I was like so miserable. So
well,
this morning was interesting.
That sounds like a pretty crazy start of the day. But I mean, like, kudos to you for even like trying and like going out. And, like, I'm gonna be in a pool and I'm still gonna body paint myself, and it's 100 billion degrees out
yeah.
today. So, like,
and it was like waterproof, nice body paint too. Like, I was all ready to like get in the pool. Like, it wasn't gonna come off. Like, it was like really nice body paint. I just didn't buy enough of it. New mistakes for 500, Alex.
Next year, swimsuit, we're going to see you like full body paint, right? Now.
I know, when I actually do this for real rather than just like a bathing suit, I'll orange up then.
You still nailed it. You look so cute, so beautiful. I'm all about it. But thank you so much for attending our
swimsuit shoot. There it is.
Sunday
swimsuit shoot.
I can't say it. But thank you so much for coming and being a part of this. We're so grateful you're here. You look amazing. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We are Geek Live here with Amber Skies Cosplay.
Amber Skies Swimsuit Sunday Cosplay.
Too many. Where can we find you on social media?
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
Amber Skies Cosplay on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Patreon.
Perfect.
And anything else that exists.
Beautiful.
Probably DeviantArt. Does anyone use that anymore?
Oh,
I don't
maybe.
Know.
There's gonna be that one guy out there is like, yes!
Yeah! Anyway, I'm all over the place.
Awesome.
So.
Well, go follow Amber. She's amazing.